From La La Land to Arizona, our next guest is a little disgruntled in her next film. Welcome, Rosemarie DeWitt. How are you today?
I'm good. Thank
really
you.
Really good to see you.
Nice to see you.
You were telling us earlier, is it your sister-in-law or your sister?
My sister-in-law.
Works in local news.
Yes, in La Crosse, Wisconsin.
Yeah. So you're kind of familiar with life, right?
Yeah, I've sat on the stage before.
There you go.
I've snuck in and watched the weather.
Right. Yeah. Okay, so you play a real estate agent during like the 2009 housing crisis.
Mm. Yeah.
But things start spiraling horribly out of control. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, right off the bat. I'm witness to sort of an awful altercation with Danny McBride.
Okay, he's great. I want to talk about him too.
He's crazy pants, but he's great.
That's him.
Like, what's wrong with him?
I know.
What is that outfit? Yeah, he's a disgruntled homeowner. It's like basically when everyone bought in to the big McMansions thinking they could afford it and they couldn't, and he felt victimized by it, and he sort of takes matters into his own hands, and it goes on kind of like a horror movie comedy caper through the desert.
Funny. So yeah. Danny McBride, who you just saw there in the mask, tell us, he's kind of a bumbling, funny kidnapper.
Well,
what are some of the crazy things he does?
We know Danny McBride as like the goofy, bumbling guy that you kind of always root for. But in this movie, he crosses over a line, and then he crosses over another line, and then he becomes a full-blown psychopath. Mm. And I am running through the desert in a bra with high heels at the end of the movie, trying to get away from him.
Wow.
And he's nuts. I mean, he's not Danny, but the characters he plays are crazy.
It'd be like a dark, it's like a dark, violent comedy, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
That turns into like a slasher film.
Okay, now this, we have to see a clip now, because that sounds amazing.
And if it's too modest for you, we can upgrade to a princess deck or a tanning ledge.
Yeah, pools for the kids, mostly.
Oh, wonderful. How many do you have?
One from my first marriage, two from the second.
I'm wife number three. Well, third time's a charm.
Yeah, three strikes, you're out.
Barry. Well, Harding is a wonderful place to raise a family. My daughter and I just moved here and she loves it. Probably just kids.
That does not sound like kids.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Wow, and there's a homeowner hanging from a ceiling fan. You know, like it's dark, it's social commentary.
Right.
And it's fun.
We were laughing. Yeah. We were totally laughing, right? You're actually married to one of my favorite actors, Ron Livingston.
Yes.
And you guys actually met acting together, right?
Yeah, we were doing a hostage negotiator show for Fox where I would say, what are you saying, that the hostage taker will kill? You know, like 3,000 times an episode. It was meant to be like Moonlight, you know how that was,
right,
like where they meet but it was in the era of The Shield.
Right.
So by episode 3, I was like shooting people in the kneecaps
with
Ron Livingston. From Sex and the City. I was like, what happened?
From The Office and Sex and the City, one of my favorites. It was so good to see you. Thank you so
Thanks
much.
Thanks for
the
having
movie.
Me.
The movie looks amazing.
Thank you.
Catch Arizona in theaters, VOD and Digital HD on Friday. We'll be right back. Thanks again.
Thanks.
So good to see you.